Families. Lord, we beseech you that you heal our lands. We want to commit all the 47 counties in our country. It's only one county that has been spared. And Lord, we beseech you. We know that your hand can heal this land. We know, Lord, through your mercy, you can remove this plague of coronavirus in our country. Lord, we pray and beseech you to heal our land. We want to commit very many families that have lost their jobs, many companies in our country that have closed. We want to pray even for many sectors in our country that are facing crisis right now, including the church. We want to uplift them unto you, Lord, because you can bring this crisis to the end. And our Father, we want to commit each citizen of this country, including our president, into your hands. We want to commit even all the political class into your hands, Lord, that, Lord, you have mercy upon us. We want to remember all those that have contracted the virus and are there in ICU, others admitted in our hospitals. We pray, Father, that you heal them. Father, we commit ourselves unto you. And this is our prayer in Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray for the Church of Christ and those who are in various needs. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the founder of our faith, the founder of the churches, we believe and entrust in you and all the churches in Kenya, in Africa, and in the world, that Jehovah God, you will remember your people so that even the power of heads shall not overcome your people. We pray that you will fill them with great faith that Jesus Christ had when he was in this world, so that they may seek thee in truth and in spirit. Remember them, God, even at this time of hardship, that Jehovah God, in the streams of warm waters, you will lead them. And remember them now and in eternity. Remember even those who are in special and specific needs, that, Lord, you will visit them at the point of their needs. And because you are more powerful and you have promised that whatever we shall pray, in your name you shall do it. Lord, we believe that today you will do this to the Church of Christ and those who call upon your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray and believe.
Yeah.
chapter number 40 and verse 29. The word says that you give power to the faint, and to them that are without might you give strength. We come to you in weakness, praying that our God and our Father, you will fill us with strength, and you will fill us with the love for our God. And this we pray in Jesus' name. There is power mighty in the blood, in the blood. There is of chapter number 2, that God formed beasts of all
the air. And God brought them to Adam so that he could name them. We see that God had honored Adam and also gave him authority and power to name all the animals, and all the animals that Adam gave to these animals, that it was. So God never changed the name of Adam, of the animals that Adam named. In this reflection, are you honored by God enough that he can give you power and authority so that you can take care or you can do work in his church at your home? In the book of Luke, chapter number 10, the Bible says, I have given you power and authority to tread upon scorpions and serpent, and all power of the enemy is, and nothing shall hurt you. Because God has honored us, he has also given us power, even over the devil, even over corona, even over every demonic powers, because he honored us if we remain faithful unto him. Also in Matthew 16 and verse 19, a person who God honors, the Bible says, I will give you the key. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. If today we are facing so much challenges, now our question is, are we honored? If God honor us, he will also give us key. The key here stands for authority that God will give us over all things in this world. Also, the God will act as a provider, because there were many trees that God formed in the Garden of Eden, for which Adam used as his basic needs for food. And also there was plenty of joy that God ensured the joy he ensured to be in Adam by creating him a helper. As I wind up, Elijah was a prophet, and a prophet of God who nurtured and cultivated his relationship with God. And though he passed many challenges and encounters with Jezebel, but what Elijah did, he nurtured his relationship with God and cultivated it so faithfully that God himself proved his faithfulness to Elijah. Number two, there is this man called Paul, an apostle, and although Paul was not in good relationship that before with God, but what he did at trust, he was punished by God and accepted the transformation. And after this transformation, Paul was actually used by God in his ministry. So I don't know where you are today in your relationship with God. Like Paul, he made the relationship to be very pure with Christ. I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, 'cause I want to see my Jesus someday. I want to see my Jesus someday. Come on, everybody sing. I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, because I want to see my Jesus someday. I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, because I want to see my Jesus someday.
What are you doing towards strengthening your relationship? May the Lord help us to nurture and cultivate our relationship with him. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
We kindly appeal to you that you continue supporting our church. And you can send your offerings through our pay bill, which is 40-21-21-5. Let us pray. Almighty God, to turn away from you is to fall. To turn towards you is to rise. Grant us in all our duties your help. In all our problems, guidance. In all our dangers, especially this time, your protection. In all our sorrows, your peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your mind in soul, in knowledge, in fear of God, and blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen. May the Lord be with you. God bless you.
Nisamehe baba yangu.